Hello everybody, this is SV, and in today's video I will show you how to create in Cinema 4D very nice underwater composition. So let's check what we will do today. Okay, so let's start. Okay, for our underwater composition I use Redshift render. In beginning I create Redshift light, spotlight. The directional of this light coming from Z axis. So I turn down approximately 90 degrees and go up for 500 centimeters will be enough. Now please going to settings of Redshift and create environment, create Redshift atmosphere. Okay, close these windows for a moment and go to spotlight settings. In general settings, little bit increase our multiplier and change unit type to radiant power and make, I don't know, 1700 will be good. For spot settings we will use 130 degrees. And for volume settings we will use 0.1. Okay, make a render and check what we have. You see, coming some light. Now we'll change the color of this light. General settings, color, and change something like a gray-blue or... Okay, maybe like this. Like this light. Very good. Render again and you see looks like water. Looks like water, underwater, maybe ocean, I don't know. It's up to you. You can make a little bit dark, little bit light, it's up to you. What we will do now? Now we are make some underwater surface. For this I going to primitives and create a cylinder. This cylinder I turn to minus X rotation and make, I don't know, maybe 100 up to 500. Okay, and going to right view and put the cylinder around the light approximately like this. Okay, we are going to this view and now we are doing some animation for this cylinder. Total for my composition I will use 350 frames, so in frame number 0 for cylinder, for rotation P I will use 0, and frame 350 I will use 360 degrees rotation. Okay, now push left button to this K and make not spline, make liner. Same make for last K. Make a liner. Okay, check animation. Our cylinder start rotate. Very good. So now we are create some material for this cylinder. We are going to standard Redshift material. Open it. Going to edit shader graph. And start work with this material. First of all, we no need any color and no need any reflection. Select texture and noise, drag and drop. Noise, we use cell and coordinates will be 0.1. Okay, very good. After that we are going to color correction, take some color correct, put here, connect and connect to the last material. What we have, we can see here. I like to reduce little bit lights, so I going to color correct and reduce gamma 0.2 and contrast 0.2. I have like this with black spots. And now I apply this color correct, noise with color correct to my material. Take, drag and drop this blue color and go and choose overall opacity color. And may connect back to our material. What we have? We have like this. Some opacity and some black contour coming. So apply this material to our cylinder. Going to perspective view and make again render. And what you see coming some lights. When you start turn, this light will move. You see, yes, there is light, there is dark, light, dark, like a sun under the water. Okay, now we are going to the some underwater particulars. How I create it? Go to primitives and create disk. Then going to Mograph and create cloner for this disk. Drag and drop this disk inside and make settings of the cloner. Okay, first of all, disk will be, I don't know, very small, maybe radius 1, segments 1, and only 10-12 rotation segments will be very, very small. You can see, yeah, like this. Okay, in cloner settings, I will use mod grid array, make it 10, 10, 10, and I don't know, maybe I will use 2000, 2000, 2000. Okay, okay, okay. What I have? I have many, many particles. You see, yeah, many particles coming around. Okay, now I apply for this cloner Mograph effector and random effector. Okay, what settings I will use for random effector? First of all, going to parameters, and on parameters I will use position and rotation. Position will be 500, 500, 500, and rotation will be 1000, 1000, 1000. And to give some moving for this object, I'm going to effector and random mode apply turbulence. Okay, now when I play, I can see some particles start moving, but it's very fast, very fast. To reduce the speed, I'm going to animation speed of random effector and reduce up to 5%. Check again. Okay, particles start moving. Try to render. Somewhere here. I can see some particles under the water. So we have to apply some texture for these particles. For texture, I use Redshift self-illumination texture. Go inside, double-click. Shaders graph and change color illumination color up to middle gray, 50% of gray, and apply this to our disk. Check again, render again, and we have all our particles. It's visible now. Very good. Also, I like to go to render settings, redshift settings, and apply motion blur to make some motion blur for these particles. I push enable and change little bit settings here. Little bit reduce start and increase end. It's giving for us more blur for any motion animation. Okay, render and check how it looks like. You see these particles start little bit moving. Very good. So now we are create a camera. For my tutorial, I will use motion camera. I create motion camera. Okay, spline we no need, we can delete the spline. Go to the top view, take a camera, turn maybe like this, push back. I don't know, maybe about 1000, just in beginning of our particles, yeah? And okay, look through the camera. Very nice, very nice. Maybe we will turn a little bit down. For this we are going to camera, motion camera, and change this angle like this. Okay, now we have to create some underwater land. For this land I will use standard, oh sorry, delete, primitives, landscape. For landscape I will use high of the landscape 500 and size of the landscape 5000 up to 5000, and little bit increase our segments 200 up to 200. Go top view and drag little bit forward. We need somewhere here our land. Okay, try to render and check what we have. So now it already looks like very nice, very nice underwater surface. And now we are create some material for this land. Going to Redshift standard material, open edit shader graph, and I will use some texture which you can going to generate texture and take from my desktop, just standard texture, going drag and drop and make a like diffuse color. Also you see, yeah, this texture coming. Also I like to use this texture for bump. How I do it? Hold a counter on the your keyboard and drag and drop down. You just make a copy of this texture and go to utilities, take a bump map and drag and drop on the your working area. Okay, but texture, if you like to apply for bump, it should be in gray scale, gray color. For this I will use a color correct. Take color correct, connect this texture to color correct, and color correct just to look how it will be. You can connect to final material to check what is going on. Take color correct and take out saturation scale up to zero, and it's coming gray, you see. Okay, connect to bump material, and from the bump map drag to this blue one, go to overall and make bump input. Okay, and now our material have a bump. So drag this material to our land scale, push here and go to projection, make a cubic, it will be good for us, render and check what we have. Okay, looks like very nice material, but I like to take out from this material reflection up to zero. We no need any reflection from this material. And I like to make some displacement. For displacement in Redshift render we have used some additional tag. So push on your landscape, go to tags and select Redshift tags. Here you have to choose a Redshift mesh. Open, it's applied to our landscape, then enable our tessellation and enable our displacement. Displacement we can make 10 and 10 up to increase. Okay, going back to our material, use same texture with same color correction, but from utilities add displacement. Drag and drop here like texture map, and displacement we have to apply not to erase material, Redshift material, to final material. Take out, drag here to the blue one, and displacement. Okay, this is final our material for land, underwater land. So render and check what we have. Okay, you see it's coming nice texture and looks like very nice. Now we work little bit with camera. Push a camera, go to tag and create Redshift tag camera. Here I will use bokeh, like usually enable, and COC radius make a 5. Render, and you can see some of the parts will be blurred. Background will be blurred, and this is will be in focus. So very nice. And what we will do now? We will create some underwater object, some, I don't know, fantastic object, like in my video you can see, yeah, some, I don't know what is this, some bacteria, or I haven't any idea what is this, but looks like very nice. How to create it? Go to primitives and create standard sphere. Push up. Okay, and make 25 centimeters radius. Going to type and use icosahedron type. Make only 10 segments. Okay, what we will do now? I will use some additional plug to make a solo of this sphere. I have this additional plug. If you haven't, you can use a solo view, solo single, and you have only this sphere. Yeah, but I prefer use this button. You push and you have only sphere. It's more easy for me. Okay, first of all, I have to take out a motion camera view, and now I go to sphere and solo view. Okay, make the sphere like a editable object. Then going to polygons and select all of them, just to be sure that all of them selected. Then right click and choose matrix extrude. The matrix extrude, go to settings and make 3 steps up to 25 centimeters and scale, reduce scale 50 50 50, and rotation make 10 degrees 10 degrees 10 degrees. Apply, and you have like this very strange object. Okay, maybe we 25 centimeters we little bit reduce, and you have like this very strange object. Okay, very nice. So now we are apply some material. For this object I will apply 2 material. So I go to redshift, create standard, create redshift material, standard material, and second one will be redshift self illumination material. So first of all, for this object I drag and drop standard material. Later I will give some color. And now I go to, where is it, sorry, I cannot find. That's very strange. Okay, 0 0 0. Very strange, but I cannot find on the top. Okay, now it's clear. Very good. So go to top view. Make a selection by polygons, make live selection. On the settings of live selection, disable this, only select visible elements, and hold shift on your keyboard and make select only ends of this, I don't know, this legs, or only ends, like this. Make around carefully. Okay, little bit here, maybe here. Very nice. Middle click and go to the right view. Hold shift on your keyboard and select from this view angle, like this. Very nice. Okay, I think everything selected. Again, middle click and front view, hold shift and select which is remaining. Okay, I think we selected everything. How to check it? Go here and make some rotation. Okay, we select everything. And now we are drag and drop. Oh, where is our material? Sorry, material, this material. We are drag and drop our self-illumination material to selected area, like this. And what we have? For our sphere, apply two materials, like a main material and material which is for only selection area. Okay, go back to model view, take out this and little bit pick up the sphere. Okay, very nice. Very nice, and go to the view from the camera. Try to render and we will see what we have. Okay, you see very interesting object. Okay, so we will change color for self-illumination material. I will use green color. And we change color for main material of this object. I will use a dark green. Maybe like this, without any reflection. So, check again. Okay, I like it. I like it very much. So now we are create some animation for this object. How we will do it? Go to sphere, go to tags, and create a vibrate tag from cinema tags. Vibrate tag. For this tag we will use only position and only rotation. Okay, position we will use 1000, 0, 1000. And speed will be 0.1. For rotation I use 350 degrees and 0.1. Okay, so when I push a play, my objects start moving. You see, yes, it's moving, and moving only by X and Z. Okay, very nice. So going to top view, take this sphere and put somewhere close to our light, middle of our scene. Go to camera, go to object, and focus object we will use our sphere. Okay, very nice. Now we are going and we are make duplicate of the sphere. Just push contour, drag up, push contour, drag up, push contour, drag up, and make, I don't know, totally 5 sphere. Okay, this sphere we put somewhere here. This sphere somewhere here. Somewhere here and in this area. And we can change little bit as we put. Okay, sorry. Little bit up. Maybe somewhere here. Okay, very nice. So, render and check what we have. You see, this sphere in the focus, all other not in the focus. I think we have little bit pick up, little bit put up. Or lens scale down. Okay, check again. Okay. Now I like it. So, last step, we are going to render settings. For render settings, samples I use 4 and 16. It's not necessary to make a good quality. I use motion blur. Now I'm going to system, bucket render, and make bucket size 256 maximum. So, output, I use HD. Widescreen 1280576. I'll use all frames, 25 frames per second, and save folder. I use PNG and save folder. I will use underwater folder. Save and push render. So when my render completed, I'm going to After Effect. In the After Effect, I make a double click, and from underwater I take first page and make import. Automatically comping import of all my frames which is rendered. Yes, drag and drop to new composition. Okay, maybe a small change, yes, because I rendered it before my lessons. So now we create some, add some few effects. Double click here, and from desktop take a sound space atmospheric from Video Copilot. Drag and drop down, it's enough. Additionally, create new adjustment layer, and for adjustment layer I use Magic Bullet Suite, Magic Looks. Like usually I create something from Blockbuster, maybe. Oops, sorry, I go somewhere here, drop down, and maybe some, I don't know. Okay, I like this, Collins. Very nice, it's already created. Now I go again to layers, new, solid, just black color. Going back, push on your keyboard, T is coming to opacity. Make first keyframe, going 5 frames more, make a 0, going somewhere here, make a keyframe, going end, and make like this. What you have finally, to full screen, full view, and check. So very nice underwater composition with some small particles which is created in Cinema 4D, with very nice sound from Video Copilot. And if you like this tutorial, please subscribe, please share to your friends, and goodbye, see you next time.